So today we want to play a bit with the menu and create those three links with a background of green and a color of white, and also a bit of spacing between the content of it and the for each of those links. So we want to start creating this top menu over here, which is basically composed of three buttons or three squares that look like buttons. They are green inside, they have a border, like a dark gray border, and some white text inside it that's centered inside those green boxes, right? And as far as I can see, it will also have at some point a width, like how much does it occupy or how much of the web page the green square sits in. So let's start with the simple thing, creating something that has cooking contact and about in it, and then maybe we evolve into styling it, right? So in order to do that, we want to get back to our browser, to our editor, actually not our browser, and we want to select this h1 and p and remove it. So yeah, that's it, and the other one on top, the h1 as well. And we want to start with an anchor tag that's just an a. Okay, and then we want to add some content to it, so space, and let's remind ourselves it's cooking contact and about. Okay, so cooking, that's it, hit enter, do another a tag.
Another a?
Yeah, another a, and the content would be contact, and another a tag, and the content of it would be
in contact in
about. Yeah, to navigate from one page to another, we'll start using the anchor tag, right? That's what A stands for. Now if you save it, did you save it?
Yes.
Cool. And I'll press Alt Z over here. We can see that this A and cooking has generated an A tag with closing and opening and closing tag, and then inside it has cooking, right? And then it generates another one over here, and then another one. So this is AAA, right? If we look into our browser, let's see, do we have a localhost here? Localhost 3000, in case you forgot. We can see, I'll zoom in a bit, we can see that we have cooking, contact, and about, like that. So now let's get back to it, because if we click on it, nothing happens, right?
Yeah.
Now let's get back to it, and in order to add a parameter, or an attribute, not a parameter, an attribute to a tag in HTML using pug, we want to put after our tag round parentheses. But we'll do it in a smart way, so I'm going to teach you a shortcut.
Okay.
And what you want to do, Graziella, you want to, firstly, the intention is to select a piece of the code that looks more or less unique, right? So it's like it doesn't repeat in other scenarios. And as far as I can see, A and space doesn't repeat in other scenarios, because if you just select A, and I'll help you with that, and press Ctrl D now, it's going to select this A and the A in contact and the A in about.
Okay.
So we don't want to select all those ones. We just want to select the A tags.
A and space, no?
So I want you to select A and space, yeah. So select A and space. And now press Ctrl D twice.
Ctrl D?
Yeah. So now we've entered multi-select, which means we are going to edit all those selections at the same time. So I want you to press left arrow.
Left arrow.
Yeah, that's right. That's right what you're pressing, left. Cool. So now you're in front of A, and now you can press the right arrow. So you go after A, right arrow, right, that's it. So now you can do round parentheses, so shift 9.
Shift 9.
Yeah, see, so you put round parentheses all over the place, right?
Yeah.
And now our attribute is called href, hyperlink reference, or something like that. So href, href.
Hash.
href. That's the attribute, right? So let's save it. Let's see what happens. So if we save it, we can see that the A tag has received an href attribute. It doesn't have any value yet, but it received an href attribute, all of them. So this one has an href, this one has an href, right? So now I want you to type equal key, that's it. And now double quotes, shift 2. Okay, so in the double quotes, I want you to type just one slash And then press escape to exit the multi-line. Press escape. And now with your down arrow, you're gonna go to the second one.
Down?
Yeah. Okay. And over here, we want to say contact.html.
Like that?
Yeah, or... contact.html. And you'll find out in a second why we do this. And the third one, which is over here, is about.html.
About?
Yeah, about. And just for the sake of it, let's also do this one as index.html. .html. Now, when we land on our page, the cooking section or the cooking page is going to be the first one that we see. After that, we can navigate to another one. We can navigate to contact. We can navigate to about. But the very first time we land on our page, if we don't type anything else, we just type mypage.com, whatever it is, right? It's going to land on the cooking one and it's going to get served that index.html page. Okay. Now let's save it. Yeah. So once we saved it, we can see that the href has received the value of index.html, of contact.html, and of about.html, right? So when we go back to our browser, this has changed a bit. Mm-hmm. Now, if we click on the first one, it's going to go to the index.html over here. It's going to work. However, if we click on the second or on the third, it's going to go to a page that doesn't exist yet. So now let's click on about. You can see about, right?
Mm-hmm.
So far we got the links working as the links, not the pages that are going to respond to the links, right? So with that said, now let's grab those ones in something. So hit enter, tab, and type nav for navigation. And now let's select all those three. So select all those three lines.
Like that?
Yeah, select it or drag down. Yeah, that's it. And press tab. So now, just for a second, press shift tab. Let's see what happens with shift tab. Yeah, and now control S. So what happened right here, I'll show you in a second, is that the nav and all the A tags are at the same level, and that's not what we are looking. We are looking to wrap the anchor tags inside the different tag, which we call nav for navigation.
Mm-hmm.
So it will be easier to position them later on, either on the center or on the top or wherever you position them, it will be easier as we don't have to calculate for each of the links where it has to be. We just have to position the nav, and whatever the links are inside the nav will also be displayed. So now if you press tab over there, and too many tabs. No, don't press backspace, shift tab.
Shift tab?
Yeah, shift tab. Backspace is gonna remove.
Okay. Right,
so save it. Okay, don't save, and I'm gonna open index.html one more time. So if we look now, we can see that the anchor tags are inside the nav. So by indenting it in PUG, come on. By indenting it in PUG, it means now the anchor tags are children of nav. Okay?
Mm-hmm.
Cool. So now, let me not say that, because I kept opening it so it's easier for you to see what happens, right? But now, right now we want maybe to style them a bit, right?
Yeah.
So let's go into the head section and under title or on top of title, it doesn't matter. It has to be inside the head.
Over here?
Well, it's either under title or on top of title. Let's create a new line. Let's type a style tag.
Style.
Yeah, style.
Style.
And press enter and tab. Enter, tab. Now, we want to select the navigation tag and then we want to select the anchor tag inside it. So you can type nav space A. No, not no. Capital A. And space. And then put curly braces.
That?
Yeah, enter. And now let's do background color. So type BAG hyphen color. It's background, just a second, hyphen or dash color. So in CSS, we have a property and a value, The property is background color and the value would be green, right? Colon. It's colon, R. Colon means... Cool. Okay, space. It's okay.
Space.
You're gonna learn. Yeah. You're gonna get more comfortable with that quite soon. So let's type a color like green. Okay, save it. So now what we can see is that in index.html, well, let me save it again. Something is not right. What's not right? What is not right? You can see it. Okay, we have an error. Cool, that's nice. Let's look at this error. It's saying that it doesn't like this curly brace. And that's because over here, if for just a second, I will remove this. You'll see.
Space or?
Just for a second, I'm going to remove this. I'm going to put the error back then, but you'll see what happens. So I remove the error for a second. But right now, we wanted to have nav space A, and what we ended up with, it was nav, a nav tag with a content of A space in it. So in order to tell PUG, well, don't treat this content as a nav tag and some content in it. Treat it as text. We want to add a dot after the style, so add a dot after the style and press save. Okay, save. Okay. Why doesn't it take the save? Cool. So now, when you press the dot in PUG, you told, well, whatever follows after treat is as text. So now we can see that we have a nav A selector over here, and then a set of rules. One of them is background color with the value of green. So what we can see is that our links have a background color of green, right? Cool. What we can continue to do is to style those buttons. For example, we can put a semicolon at the end of green, enter, and do color white. Color is the property and the value with colon. So it's always property, colon, value, property, colon, value, property, colon, value, and so on, white. Save it. Okay, don't know why when you save it, it doesn't take it, so I have to save it over here. But that's cool. And now I got something that looks a bit better.
Yeah.
And now let's do one more. Let's type semicolon, which is punct și virgulă. It allows us to add one more rule. So the rule would be padding. The padding will be looking at it in a second. Let's first padding and type colon. And then the value of it is, let's do 10 pixels, a random one, right? 10 pixels, 10 px. Save it. Okay, and I also have to save it. Yeah. Cool, so now we can see that there's more spacing between the words. What I'll do in the browser, I will right-click this one and choose Inspect. And then I'll also hit Control Plus a few times for you to see it better over here.
We can try with 5 pixel.
Yeah. So what you want to do is, inside this inspector over here, so this one, come on, this one, you want to click on that value. And if it becomes blue, it means you're doing the right thing. See, it becomes highlighted with light blue. So now if you use your up and down arrow, right, you can see that the padding increases or decreases. Now I'll also hit Control 0, but not this one, sorry. Control 0 in the website, because this is how it actually looks like. That's the 100%. I use Control Plus for you to see it better, but I'll do it 100%. And then for those 8 pixels again, I'm gonna increase and decrease it, see? So the more padding I have, the more those links are gonna be, the content of it are gonna look more apart. So we can play later on with those values. So far we've created this menu that has 3 links into it. One of them is working and 2 other ones are working as it points to different pages, but the pages are not present, so it's gonna give us 404s. And we've also started to style a bit our links, and we've added a background of green and a color of white, and we also increased the spacing inside each of those elements. Okay, so in the next lesson, we are going to style our buttons to have a proper green background, a color of white centered with a border and a bit of space between them. So let's get on with it in the next lesson.